just naming some things that we do as a DJ and audiovisual production company when we do personal weddings and events. Set up for today's wedding for Mr. and Mrs. McKnight, only McKnight. My client's first name is Only, y'all, so y'all know it's only gonna be a good night with who? With DJ Snoopy, y'all. Right now we at the Only Level out here in Dallas, y'all. Out here in Dallas, got the photo booth. We're gonna rock the party, y'all. We're gonna be back over in this corner over here is the planner, y'all. She been busy, y'all. This is the setup here for the DJ. We right here, y'all. We're gonna rock the house, y'all. Y'all see this, y'all see the blazer on top, y'all. One multicolor, the master thing. It's wedding day, y'all. They're doing a ceremony right now. But it's all due to Bluetooth. And the home which you will endeavor to establish. Stand for a few minutes, y'all. It's gonna be packed. I promise.
Keep the solemn vows you are about to make. Live with tender consideration for each other. Conduct your lives in honesty and in truth, and your marriage will last. Your home will be lasting. This commitment to marriage will be a blessing to you and will be a blessing to others. It should be remembered as you manifest.
Boy, that detail work from the mother box, y'all. The detail, y'all. She going DJ Snoopy. On the level, y'all. On the level. Get back in this corner, y'all. Getting ready right now. Yeah. It'll be a beautiful sight. Go sound check right now. My second ideal thing is I always like to find a video platform that can show you my DJ skills, the audience that I target in their event, and don't have a delay or relapse or from me posting for, you know, with their restrictions. So I do find it interesting that TikTok, what is the next one? CapCut. I really like CapCut because it for short form videos, it kind of like lets you go in there and dive in, do a little 20-second, 30-second video that's really grabbing the person's attention. For his long videos, of course, I like the original, which is YouTube. Vimeo, I like Vimeo, V-I-M-E-O. I like that video platform as well because, like I said, it could be over 3 to 4 minutes long. And I think that's the platform, or that's the video platform that I've chose of choice. And so with that being said, I'm going to show you different ways that I like that platform. Hey, how you doing? This is Broderick with Any Event Productions. I'm in Full Sail, taking audio visual, and this is my video, long form video. My name of my company is Any Event Production. This is my home office that you see, and I'm just coming in here like I like to come in here and have some focus points to relax, and if you would say my man cave. This is just a portion of my video that I'm shooting for my long video. Check it out, y'all. Some of the stuff that I like to do. Don't mind the mess on the floor. This is just my home office. I'm still trying to put it all together and straighten it up. Here in Texas, it is very cold today. I'm not for sure why it's so cold in late months of March. Normally at this time of the year, it is pretty weather outside. However, it is cold. But I am want to focus and let you know in regards to my video that I really do like the production part of Full Sail because it lets you excel in the field, the line of field that you like, and that's just what I like. As I was looking for a school in regards to that, in regards to putting this video together, I found some challenging issues with other platforms. Some of the platforms didn't allow you to go past, like I said, the 3 minute mark. Some was okay with it, so I think the way I'm doing my video and the cuts and the edits and things of that nature. I think it's going to be a pretty cool video. Just learning how to put it all together at this given time. So hopefully this video will come together smoothly, and then we can see what we need to do in the future in order to put more videos like this together. So I do want to let you know that by putting this video together, it's taught me a lot. I'm going to try to implement it with some hashtags and key points of the video. I'm walking in my house. As you can see, it's a little nifty outside. And so that's what we're doing. We're hoping that this video can teach us going forward, you know, what we need to do in order to stay and stay focused on the topic in making this video. So, you know, throughout this course, we did find that learning from different platforms, video platforms, some are great, some are not great. Learning the different hashtags, what hashtags are about. I think hashtags are very important, as I use hashtags all the time when I post on social media, trying to get the hashtag to me. If someone is talking in regards to DJing, like when I DJ a lot of weddings and I put the word, hey, I'm a great DJ, do you need DJ service? Hashtag DJ. Anybody looking for DJ in my particular area, and they type in DJ or hashtag DJ, I'll pop up eventually with the post, like mainly on Instagram or even Facebook. I have found it a little bit challenging on TikTok. However, you can do that, but it kind of doesn't generally target your local area. It kind of just broadens it out for anyone looking for that. So with those hashtags, you definitely got to be using the keyword hashtag for what you want your target audience to be. So if you're a videographer or camera guy, gamer, you can use those hashtags. And that's what I do when I'm doing my work, my weddings, or if I'm even doing camera work for a studio. I have a hashtag word camera, cameraman, or production management, or audio visual, or something like that. And it targets more people looking for that type of service. So that's what I found mostly important about using the hashtags. Back to what I like to do and what this video is about. It's about the platform. Like I said, VIMEO. I can never pronounce that word right, but I like that video because one, it lets you go past the 3 minutes. Two, it's different areas of the video that doesn't look for keywords to flag you, and that's what you don't want. Some platforms look for certain words or listen to certain words, like Facebook, if you would say. They want you to put in the reel, and then from that reel, it really doesn't kind of go anywhere because it kind of limits your time. YouTube, it depends on what you're trying to target. It could get flagged as well from different words, especially if you're playing music in the background or you're doing any voiceovers. But this platform that I like, it doesn't necessarily have to be anything like that. And I'm going to end my video, and hopefully this video comes together to your liking. Again, my name is Broderick Orchie. I'm in full sail for audio visual degree. Thank you.